everybody, this is your boy JC. How y'all doing today? Alright, what I'm gonna do is just a quick installation video of our M.2 SSD inside the Asus ROG G15 Advanced Edition. And this particular one comes with two SSD slots, and they're both Gen 3. So if you have a Gen 4, forget about it. You're just gonna waste your time and waste your money. So make sure if you're gonna get an internal SSD, get a Gen 3. It could be any brand. But what I'm going with right here, go with the bad boy, the Samsung 970 EVO Plus. Now this is one of the baddest Gen 3 on the market. It got its own data migration software like Macrium, but that's going to be in a separate video. So subscribe and tune in for that one. And I got two of them on deck. I got a 1 terabyte and a 2 terabyte. You already know I'm a Asus fan for life. So you already know I'm a Asus out. This right here is an enclosure. This is a Asus ROG Strix Arian enclosure. This you could put your internal SSD inside of it, connect it inside your PlayStation 5 or your computer and transfer data onto it. It's very cool. And this right here is a very thin heatsink. This is the Ice PC. It's very thin, 1.5 millimeters. This should fit inside the very limited space inside your laptops. So I'm doing this for my boy Beast Mode Gaming. He's been watching my videos and he's been making comments. He got some nice contents, he got some nice gameplay. So if you're looking for some nice gameplay contents, check him out. Beast Boy Gaming. He's awesome. Alright, I'm doing this for him. And if anybody wants to find this video useful, you can go ahead and watch it, share with your friends and family, and even subscribe. I'd really appreciate that. Alright? So anyway, let's get into it. Like I said earlier, it comes with 11 screws, 4 in the front, 3 in the middle, and 4 in the back. And just to let you guys know, when you're going to open this bad boy, be very careful because it comes with 2 ribbons. And those 2 ribbons are for the RGB lighting, so you got to be very careful or you can snap it. And if you got anything flat, like a credit card or a guitar pick or something, you need something very flat. You could go underneath and prop it up, or if you got little fingernails, you can simply just pull it up. The space is not that narrow, so you can't use the fingernails and just prop it. We just got to be very careful. So I'm gonna do this real quick for you guys, and for you, Beast Boy Gaming. All right, check it out. Here comes the fun part. Like I said, you need something flat to go underneath here to prop it up. I gotta be very careful because you got 2 ribbons for the RGB lighting. So I ain't got nothing really flat, so I'm gonna go old school. Actually, I'm gonna use my card. Be very gentle. Or if you got the fingernails, like I said, you can use the fingernails and just prop it up, but you just gotta be very gentle. Alright? So I'm gonna do this real quick. Just gotta adjust myself a little bit. Right. Just be very gentle. Be very gentle. Gently move down the sides. Gently move down the sides like this. Alright. Just be very gentle. Be very gentle. It out. Just gonna rest it right here. Cool. Now we're inside. Now, this looks a little bit sloppy. I'm gonna slide it over a little bit more. I already snapped one of those cables. Yeah, my bad. So I'm gonna go a little bit closer. So as you can see, this is SSD 1 and SSD 2. Let me zoom in. You can see right here, SSD 1 and SSD 2. I know this kind of ghetto work, but it's all right. This one is for the OS. This is a Samsung 512 gigabytes they got inside here. It's very slow, mediocre. This is the one they got the OS. So I'm gonna put in this one terabyte Samsung 970 EVO Plus inside here. And then, actually, yes, I'm gonna put it right here. And then tune in for the next video. I'll show you how to migrate the OS from this one onto the new one. But this one right now, this video is just to show you how to install SSD inside the Asus. All right. So let me just bust this bad boy out of the box real quick. So let me get my trusty Phillips screwdriver with a magnetic tip. All right. This is the satisfying part. Let me just zoom out. Here we go. The bracelet seals right here. And this comes with a 5-year warranty. See, unreal performance realized. Okay. I'm so excited. Bust the seals to the side. Oh, man, this one is really sealed in. All right. Take it out real quick. All right. Woo. Yeah, I'm just going rough on this one tonight. This is the bad boy right here. Yeah, look at it. In all its glory. Samsung 970 EVO Plus. V9 SSD. It comes in a nice little case. Like you're buying a brand new watch, it comes in a nice case. Yeah, baby. Feels so special. All right, let's take it out the box right here. Take a look at it. That's the beauty right there. All right, let's see if there's anything else that comes inside the box here. If it comes with any paperwork and anything that we should be aware of. Oh, it comes with a thick booklet, so I'll just keep this to the curb. And this is a solid state drive, installation guide. I'll come with like a seal, so you know this is the authentic, ain't a fake one. Let's see what we got here. Some booklets, so I guess it's good. I think this booklet's gonna tell you some stuff, blah blah blah. Anyway, that's not important right now. So, like I said, make sure you got a Phillips with a magnetic tip. So let's zoom in right now and show you how to uninstall. So I'm just gonna get this out of the way. This one is this screw is very small, so you gotta be very careful. That's why I stressed it again. Make sure you get a Phillips screwdriver with a magnetic tip. Let me show you. See how small that is? That is very small. Alright, let me just get it out of the way. I don't lose it. And let me get this joker out of the way. This right here, it's served me for a while. This one I've been serving for a while. This the PNY M.2 is a 1 terabyte. It's been serving its purpose, but it's so slow. It's rubbish. So kick rock. Now, where the bad boy at? So this is it right here. Boom. So what I'm gonna do, just since I got some time, I'm gonna see if I can put this heatsink on this bad boy right here, the ice PC, onto the nasty glow film. Just gotta replace, gotta remove it. And line that bad boy up. Oh, it's very sticky too. Line that bad boy up real nice on top like this. And lay it on thick. Lay it on. But this is what it looks like. See, boom, that's all you need. And the adhesive is very sticky. So you just remove the blue film. Boom. And just put it on top. End up real nice, and that's it. So let me just go ahead and slide this into the slot to show you guys. Let me go closer. So you can see. That's all you gotta do. Just slide this bad boy in. Nice nice and easy. No fuss, no fuss. And boom, that's it. Now, let me get out my screw. That's it right here, you see? Little screw with a magnetic tip. Screwdriver with magnetic tip. And be very gentle with this bad boy here. Oops, I just made a mistake real quick. Just gotta be very careful. Boom, and that's it. But remember, when you're tightening, when you're screwing it in, don't give it much tension. Once you feel a little bit of tightness, don't screw any further. You don't want to mess up the threading right here, alright? So what we're gonna do right now, I'm just gonna screw this bad boy back up and conclude the video. And then, like I said, tune in for the migration of the OS from the old SSD card onto the new one. So let me go back out for you guys. And then let me just put this bad boy up and call it a day, alright? And I really appreciate you guys for watching my videos. Don't forget, continue to subscribe. Watch my other videos. It would really help a lot. And that's pretty much it. I really appreciate you guys a lot. I just gotta do something real quick right here. Alright, let me just pop this bad boy up. So you gotta be very gentle, you know what I'm saying? Gotta be very gentle. Go to the sides and go back up here. Go on to the sides. Nice and easy. Once you hear the little pops, yeah, you got it. Boom, boom. Better make sure that it's all sealed up, you see? Look at it, all sealed. Ain't no gaps. Look again, no gaps. No gaps on this side. And on the other side. Okay, so, alright, now to screw them back in, I'm gonna call it a day. And voila, there you have it. That's how you install the internal SSD inside your gaming laptop. This one in particular, the Asus ROG Strike G15 Advanced Edition. Beast Boy Gaming, that's just for you, and for everybody else, that's for you as well. Thank you guys for tuning in. Don't forget to check out part 2, where I'm going to do the migration from the OS from the old SSD onto the new one, alright? Don't miss it. Thanks for tuning in. Love you guys. That's the speed test I get with the Samsung 970 EVO Plus. This is the speed, man. This is ridiculous. I'm loving it.